What up, what up, what up? Yep, this is what we're making. Getting ready for the alpha release. It's going to be next Wednesday, official alpha release. So from playing the game this Sunday, got a huge list of more bugs to fix. I've already fixed like over 20 of them. So now we're going to be on to some other cool stuff today. What up, Eklov? Yeah, so today's goal is one of the big problems of when I played the alpha was getting lost in this one world that I couldn't find level one. And it turned out that there was no bridge to this one island. So I fixed that. So that bug is fixed. What up? What up, Pedro? Bam. See how many we can get. So yeah, that bug's fixed. So now it's like guaranteed that on islands that you can get to them. Marza! Nice, nice. That's three in a row. Oh! Yeah, I heard. Yeah. Jonah19, what's up? What's up? What up, Thomas? Nice try. It was so close. So close. So, yep. Now that bug is fixed, what I want to do is at least be able to guide the player to level one, especially if they get in the position where it seems like they need some help. I know that was a pretty good one, right? What's up, Kobile? What up, what up? Welcome to the stream. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm creating an overworld compass and an overworld map. So a lot like in the dungeons where you can get the map or you get the compass. There are these homing or these scanner type drones that go, you send out these drones and they search the world. So it's going to be like that for the overworld. So the overworld map is not going to cover the whole map though. It's only going to cover part of the overworld. And then the overworld compass will guide you to the first boss, but not any of the other, or the first dungeon. Not any of the other dungeons. And there's going to be a mini boss encounter. So right now I've got it so where you, where's this story? Yeah, story. Here's the first mini boss is driven via the story. So if you've got four positions in your, that you've been to on the overworld, well, including dungeons and stuff like that. So, but anyways, if you have four or more positions, and you have the sword, you're going to get in this mini-boss encounter with the drop mini-boss, and he gives you the hat, the top hat, or the homing drones, whatever you want to call that. So basically, I'm going to create another story element where if you've got like 10 or 12 or maybe 15 positions, it's going to give you a mini-boss encounter with this guy that gives you the compass. So basically, if you're lost, you're going to get into a mini-boss encounter where you're going to find an item that that helps you find level one. So that's kind of how I'm going to handle that for now. Also, there's some other great ideas on here about how to kind of guide the player to level one. So, but I'll do a couple more of those as well. But for now, I'm going to start with this overworld compass, overworld map. So let's get right into it. The first thing I want to do is create an item map 0 and compass 0. Right now, there's already compasses and maps and stuff like that for the levels. So now we just need a compass 0 for the overworld. So we'll go compass 0 and map 0. And I'm going to need to redo a lot of these functions for these to make sure that doesn't break anything. What's up, Manic? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Progress is going great, dude. Will I stream the alpha version tomorrow? Yeah, probably tomorrow. So I didn't stream yesterday at all because I was really just focusing on these bugs and stuff, and just trying to haul ass with that. And I got like literally 20 bugs crossed off the list. But then there's basically this I'd kind of like to get done today. I'm probably not gonna be able to finish all that today, but still it'll be enough that tomorrow playing the alpha version will be a lot better than today. So what's up, Grim Gary? Welcome to the stream. Alex Pita, what's up, man? Cool, right on. Yeah, I'm definitely going to send it to you and Alex Pita first before I actually finally release the alpha version so you guys can try out those one bugs you're reporting from the last version. make sure it, you know, make sure the input works and stuff. Take my money. Okay. What's up, Expresso? Sorry, that might be a little loud. Cool, right on. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Yeah, Alex Pita is translating to Italian, so we'll have that in there. Oh, yeah, I stream almost every day. So, yeah, you probably just miss me. If you ever miss a stream, you can get on my YouTube. I think that link works. Let me see if that works without the capitalization. Yeah, that works. So yeah, every one of these videos is always on YouTube. Ops today? Ops today, huh? We need to op somebody? Oh yeah, probably. Probably. Yeah, I'm streaming a Pacific Coast time of about 4 p.m. usually, which is pretty late for you guys over there across the pond. Sorry about that. So it looks like I succeeded in that build. First thing I want to search for is K-item map 1, because there's going to be some things we need to change to make sure this all works. So let's add item 0 for the map 0. Let's add a compass 0 item type. Yeah, that's probably the best way to follow me, because it's a different time every day. Oh, was that you were donating? Oh, thanks, man. Oh, all right. What? 6 a.m., that's way too early. Way too early. Nice, right on. Oh, you're talking to Alex. If anybody doesn't know, Alex Pita and Mars of Power are good friends. They both live near, where is it? Milan? Is that right? No? I forget. Okay, so key 111, compass. Okay, here. Reuse text for maps. Oh, that's going to work fine. So if we just change this is map function to be 0. Plus world num levels. In fact, I wanted to set a breakpoint there to make sure that works correctly. And this too. These are pretty critically important functions right here for maps and compasses. Yeah? One song? Heck yeah. I want to go too. I've been to Greece, but I've never been to Italy. Okay, here we go. Is equipable item. Is map quantity 2 world get pause dot z. Oh yeah, this is gonna. Oh wait. Okay, add a map 1. I minus. This is a pretty. Let's think about this. The Z is going to be 0 for the map 0. So I minus K item map 0. Actually, I think it's just that now. But this needs to be checked as well. Why was that plus 1? 1 plus 1? Oh, world get pause dot z equals this plus 1. Yeah, okay, so that's going to work now. It should. We're such good friends. You're using his money to buy something. Oh, wow. Nice. 3D laser printer. What can you print on it? Oh. Drones? What? Hardwood skin for MacBook Pro? Man, this thing looks awesome. Whoa, look at that. Gosh, the world. We live in such a sci-fi world already. Yeah, good question. You have 7 laser printers? Nice. Oh, that would be sweet. That would be so sweet. Okay, that one's good. Hazmat or compass? Has map or compass? This function looks really weird. Oh, because you're giving it the item. Okay. So that's going to be item 0 as well. And this one too. And then this is item plus Z. I believe. Yeah, 0 plus 0. Yeah, I think that's going to be like that. This is another one we need to check. Yeah, I need about 43.1% more sci-fi. So you already have 0.9, I'm guessing. No, wait. Oh, sorry. I was trying to make that a 42 reference. Whoa. Sweet. Hey, what's up, Felix, Dej? Alright, Koken, what's up, guys? Welcome to the stream. I'm working on a map and a compass for the overworld. Billy Joel. Okay, got a breakpoint to check that. We got that. That looks good. Ooh, what's this? Oh, when we use the items, we gotta hook that up. These functions up. So we're gonna be able to use item map 0 and use compass 0. And we're probably not gonna need to put it in the dungeons. That's yeah. What up, Momir? Do I ever get creator's block? Not very often. I've really learned to kind of master the technique of using creativity. So what I do if I ever feel like I'm getting creator's block or whatever, I just relax. I've really learned how to relax in life, and that, you know, I do yoga every day. That probably helps too. I just, you know, keeping my body in kind of in good shape, but yoga really helps your creativity as well. You know, I mean, it's not just all stretching and stuff. That breathing actually helps a lot to keep you, you know, yoga breath, like, really keeps your creativity flowing. I don't know what it is about that, but yeah. Subconsciously too, yeah, it's just relaxing. If you ever feel like you've got creator's block or whatever, just relax. It'll come to you. It comes. Intuition. All those higher mind functions work best when you're relaxed. So usually creator's block is just a state of mind where you've got too much going on. You need to just relax. Do whatever it is that makes you relax, you know. Arcane, am I making a new map? Not really. No, I'm making a map item that reveals the map of the overworld a little bit, if you buy it. So the map you're going to be able to buy from a store in the overworld, and then the 0, the compass, you're going to get from a mini boss encounter. Yes, Momir. Yep, totally. Fixed most of the big errors in the world, Poopy. So there was definitely a confirmed bug where the Poopy Dungeon 1 that I was looking for forever, and at the very end of the stream, I was like almost there, but I couldn't get to it. There was no bridge onto the island that where Dungeon 1 was. So all I had to do was fix the bridge there, and it's all good. And I fixed a lot of other bugs too. So today I'll be doing this one more thing to kind of enhance the game so it's a little bit easier to play and get to level 1 if you're lost. So this, you're going to find a mini boss encounter. If you've wandered around and you're lost for a while, you're going to find a mini boss that just gives you the compass so you can kind of, it guides you to level 1 sort of. Uh-huh. Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that can be too. Right? Scooby? Alex Pete is calling out World Scooby. All right, Scooby. Okay. I wonder if we can use it right now. Let's just give the player the zero map. We want to give him quantity 2 to be able to use it. And then remain as marked as used. And then I'm going to turn off breakpoints just to see if this even works. Oh, yeah, running out of juice. What's going on? One of these hang on start bugs. All right. Oh, check this out, too. I got this one key. I can press a button and everything dies. Really helps debug the game fast. Pretty fun. Bam. Oh, you're dead. So, and this would be an awesome item to have for like, for speedrunners. Let's go back to the overworld. There should be some art to it though, you know, not like just everything just instantly dies. You're still waiting for map Arcane? Yes, totally. Exactly, Grim Gary. Yeah. Doing something fun. PMC, what's up? Why did I not stream yesterday? I need days off every once in a while, man. Yep, I normally stream like 6 or 7 days a week. Yesterday was that one day a week where I'm like, it's the day where I gotta take a day off. We don't have it. I wonder why. Okay, well, let's dive into these breakpoints that I set. This probably has something to do with why it wasn't giving. I think it's an is equipable item. Might be wrong. Cool. Thanks, Manic. Did I call it the red button? Huh? Oh. You asking somebody else? Okay, so yeah. Let's check out these methods, make sure everything's cool so we can be able to use this map. In fact, this is exactly what I wanted to try first, is equipable item. So item type, top hat, is map. Okay, his map. Max should be the 9th map. Cool. Item map 9. And oh, big bug right here. This should be 0. Okay, let's try that again. Oh, it's the nuke all button. It's the red button, exactly. The red button. Is there a front attack yet? No, there's no front attack, but he's that one boss is constricted to moving only north-south, so, yeah. Oh. Well, why do you feel like you're out of inspiration or out of juice? What's at the bottom of all that for you? What's up, blood? Oh, right, yeah. Was it Boogie? I think Boogie was on here. Your jokes are funny. Hey, what up, Mighty Nest? What up? Okay, so let's see if it works this time. We're checking out the top hat item. Max should be map 9, and then I is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, this is good. I'm going to delete the breakpoint here. Check that method. Compass is compass. The max should be item compass 9. Min would be compass 0. Cool. That one's done. We can proceed. All right, well, there. Now we're checking is equipable items on... is equipable diamond Don't care. Sword. Yeah, it's gonna be yes. Teleport. Come on, give me a map. Map zero. All right, this is it. So we want to check if this is a map. This should return true. Good, we got true. And quantity equals two, and world get pause as z. Let's check out worlds get pause. Didn't give us a return value, but cool, it did return true. I minus came. Yeah, I think this is good now. Let's disable that breakpoint for a second. And yeah, continue on. All right, cool. Now we got the item, the drones. We can use this. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's see if this works. So, oh, wait. We should probably clear out. Let's clear out the player's existing map. Oh, big fail. Didn't work. Okay, let's figure out what's going on there. What's up, J Lists? Welcome to the stream, man. Yeah, right on. Right. I think it's where it launches the drones in area. Yeah, exactly. I think it's good. I think that's good, man. Just don't worry about it. You'll get to it. Do things in time with your heart, you know? Your heart is, for some reason, your heart's like, dude, I'm tired of this. I don't have juice for this. I don't want to work on this right now. So, you know, follow that. Follow it into whatever else is exciting for you. There's got to be something else that's maybe exciting you more. Or maybe you need to do something else and your heart's just trying to tell you that or something. I don't know. But yeah, you're one day you'll be back at it and you'll be like, all right, nice, I got my flow again. What up, Loeb? What's up, man? Hey, if anybody has not heard Loeb's music, his music's dope. I gotta post Loeb's link. SoundCloud, Loeb, UK, right? Is it Loeb UK? Is that right? Ah, there it is. Dope music. It's the real Loeb. Need design help? What do you mean? Girls wear girls. Launch drones. Ah, well, here it is. This is the problem. So, less than zero, and then launch bio drones, same thing. Okay, let's try that one more time now. Yeah, that it? Well, cool. Directional animated deaths. Sweet. Nice job, Mighty Nest. Oh yeah, that's right. I love the look of this game. Okay, directional deaths, I got you. And your particle system. Oh, okay, I'll visit the little ninja stars and stuff. Dude, looking great. That was awesome. Oh yeah, dude, I love that. I love that isometric games for sure, man. What's up, Barkor? Oh yeah, well share, please share. Maybe I can help or someone else here can help. Whoa, nice. Right on. Cool, J-List, right on, man. I like your art. Sweet. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Cool. You can. What up, Zeith? Welcome. Zeith. Oh. What's up, buddy? Manic, I don't really know about C sharp, but I do know about C++. See if this works this time. Droning it out. Come on, drones. No? No love? Okay, I guess we gotta set a breakpoint for that. Figure out what's up. Okay, so they were launching the drones here. Pause. This should be 700. Yep. Next we got. Okay, so good. We skipped over this little bit of restrictiveness where it's checking the Z level. And now. Oh, here it is. That function messed up. Okay, let's try that again. Hey, what's up, King Nothing? Oh, yeah, classes. Yeah, Java. Hey, thanks, Kofez. Yeah, the drones are like a compass. Yeah, so the game's already had maps and compasses or these drones, right, for a while. And now it's going to have the ability to use these compasses and maps on the overworld. So, and it's only going to be for slight situations where, like, let's say you're on the overworld, you're wandering around, you're like, dude, I'm lost. I can't find level one. You're going to randomly stumble across a mini boss, which gives you the compass. And so then you use the compass on the overworld and it shows you where to go. It'll put a little red dot on your map showing you where you need to go to get that guy. I just noticed the map is 3 pixels off. Oh, Mars Power is talking about the language flame. Yeah, Vim versus Emacs. Yeah, there we go. Vala punch cards. We didn't start the flame war. It was always here. Oh, I gotta check this out. This is probably funny, huh? Be checking that out later. Amateur. Thanks, Kofez. Cheers, man. Okay, so let's launch these guys, these babies again. And it's the second function here that's just causing the trouble. This gear component has map, so that's going to be a pretty easy one to fix. Has map world get pause.z. True. What's true? Equipable. Okay. Has map or compass. K item Z. Oh, it's checking the Z right here. Here's our problem. Okay. Because originally this was all designed, so maps and compasses were only supposed to be used in the dungeons, but things have changed. Yeah, a little bit. What's up, Wissiso? Yeah, garbage collectors. I prefer languages without garbage collectors myself. I'd rather take out my own trash. What's this? Item compass zero. Yeah, let's keep that. Okay, let's launch these babies again. Oops. There. Launch the drones. Check out this method. This should be okay now. Right, we're getting past that bit. We're getting the gear for the player. We're checking the quantity needed. And then gear.count, let's step into this method. Make sure it's got the right item type. Yeah, map zero. Good. And then we should be able to find that. Yep. Good, good. Return from this, get the return value should be two. Right. And that should be return true. Bam! Fixed it. Delete this breakpoint. All right, now we're running some drones. Oh, cool. Now it's getting this call back. Let's watch the game. It's not adding it to the. Oh, it's putting him way over there. What are you guys doing trying to fill out the map over there? That's not right. Oh, Marza. Okay, so the drones are exploring a world get unexplored map pause for drone pause. Drone pause. Okay, let's turn off that breakpoint. And get on it. What should I guess it starts with drone pause and drone pause. Yeah, I guess I got to see what drone pause is right there. So let's do this again. Yeah, exactly. Do it for yourself. Actually, C++ is kind of a DIY type language. So it's like, I always say it's like the manual transmission car versus an automatic car. It's a lot like that. Java, C Sharp, and some of the other higher level languages like, Go and Rust and D. These are a little more automatic, just a little bit though. Don't know, I haven't really actually looked at Rust or Go or D myself. I just heard this stuff, so I really don't know what I'm talking about. Drone pause, what is that? That's important. Is that a static? I think it's a static of this class. Area drone pause. Yeah, it's invalid. So if it's not valid, good. Hook it up to the current pause, which should be 700. All right, so let's run it one more time. Let it break, and the drone pause should still be 700. Yep, structs are not always public, they're just defaulted to be public. Oh, I've never seen this. This looks like a good article. Is there a difference? Oh, C sharp. Oh, so in C sharp, you use structs to define value types as opposed to reference types. Oh, okay, wow. So in C sharp, a struct is a lot, is like nowhere near like a class. Yeah. Yeah, the link, right? Nice, Marza. What's up, Overcaster? Oh, nice, Vlad. Right on. Good. You got an idea. Sweet. Okay, so this is the method right here. Get unexplored map paws. The drones are right now, these drones are filling out the map, but they're starting in the lower left of the whole overworld, not at anywhere near the drone paws. But let's make sure the drone, yeah, the drone paws is still 700. I bet you it's this get unexplored map paws function. What's this gonna do? Okay, so this is going through every map pause. If you already have, okay, let's check this out. Let's run to, well, we can just delete this. So the max disk squared is really, really big. We shouldn't have any map positions at this point, especially what's this position? X pair dot second dot get pause. This would be a lot easier to debug if I took this out and put it as a variable. But I don't think it's gonna be too much of an issue here. Disk squared equals center dot distance squared. So the distance squared from here is 49. Is less than good. Max disk squared equals disk squared. Yeah, red equals the pause once again. Next time, disk squared 64. This one's not going to be closer. This seems to be the right method. Like nothing in here seems wrong at all to me. Curious, curious, curious. You're back and you're mostly alive? Why are you mostly alive? Yeah. Yeah, Iarkoken, you've got me really thinking about C++ lately. And so I actually started watching Jonathan Blow's videos. If anybody hasn't seen this is actually kind of interesting to us game developers. But if you haven't seen his videos language, where the heck is this again? Jonathan Blow language. Oh, check it out, Jai language primer. Wow. Somebody started writing a language primer for it. Cool. Well, here's actually a pretty good intro then to it. If you guys haven't seen this is a really pretty cool, 'cause there are a lot of disadvantages to using C++. It's kind of an archaic language if you think about it. And for me, at least, it's one of the best languages I could be using for this project. But there's so many things which I wish were better about C++. You know, I wish it were simpler. I wish it didn't have headers, things like that. And so, if you actually watch, if you, I don't, let me try and get the links to his other, so this. Because the videos kind of explain what he's talking about. Yeah, here's one of his videos. And then, here it is. Here's what I'm talking about. This whole series of
Some ideas about a
videos.
new programming language for games.
Kind of cool. Yeah. Wow, right on. Is there a language for writing languages? Yeah, pretty much. Usually languages are written in earlier languages. So, actually, like what I was talking about, Jonathan Blow, him writing his language, at first he just wrote it so it just outputted C. So he's got this awesome new language, simpler, it's rad features and stuff, and then it just outputs C, and then you can compile C however the heck you want on pretty much every platform there is ever. So yeah, it's true, right? Yeah, that's kind of a hindrance to the C sharp. Yeah. You can. All right, so what happened to this? Why did that not work? Let's try this one more time without the breakpoints. Okay, I'll figure this out. It's in here somewhere. Set the breakpoint here. Delete that one. Delete this one. Delete. Maybe not this one. Yeah, Loeb, sorry. Yeah, so that's why it doesn't sound very good, is because you're actually hearing it recorded from my speakers, and that's just an issue of my laptop and not being able to record the desktop audio very well. For me to actually record desktop audio with Open Broadcaster, I would have to install this thing called SoundFlower, and it's killed the stream several times. Like, SoundFlower is just this bad thing for live streaming. So you're actually hearing the sound of the game played through my laptop speakers, so they're already low quality, and then you're hearing it recorded once with my laptop's microphone. So that's why the quality of the audio is so bad. But dude, trust me, when you play the game with headphones, it's a lot better. I mean, that's actually, next time I play the alpha, maybe I'll try and play with headphones. What's up, Boogie? No, they're not doing a flood fill. They're doing a search for the nearest point to their start point of their search. So they should be starting to search from right here at this 700 point, and then moving outward from that. Oh, Alex Pita, you're seeing blinking shadows because the game is not the the most, what do you call it? It's not the frontmost window. So check it out. When I go back to the game and I alt tab back in, you're seeing the shadows look fine, everything's good. But when I alt tab out, it sort of blinks and it runs slower because I actually schedule the game to run at 1/10 of the speed so that it doesn't use as much CPU if you alt tab out. So English. All right, so let's try it one more time. Let's follow closer look this time at these drones. So they do this thing called there's a schedule, right? There's a callback. Every time the callback happens, it gets a new unexplored map position. And it's supposed to be based on the drone pause. And so that would be the center variable being passed into here, which should be 700. Okay, so this algorithm, let's run it once again because I'm still not seeing anything wrong with it. And ret is 000. How can that be the closest point? You know what? Okay, so next time, let's not set a breakpoint there. Let's set a breakpoint in here. Oh, it might be this. Might be secrets. No, it can't be. So yeah, let's set a breakpoint here. So, for example, one position where I'd love to check on would be 600, which would be just to the left. So if 600. What's up, General Domo? Welcome to the stream, man. An easy, simple program for beginners. I would recommend Game Maker or maybe Pygame. And also, good advice for beginners, check out Extra Credits videos on game design. Just look for Extra Credits game design on YouTube, and you're gonna get a bunch. You're gonna get a playlist of some awesome videos to check out, especially when you're new to game development. Okay, so let's run these drones again, and this time we're gonna set that breakpoint at 600, so we can see. Oh, nice! You got your squirrel game started. Yes, Woogie. Yeah. Yes. Is that ice and snow he's on? Yeah. Ah, dude, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. Yeah, nice sound effect. This is so great. Oh, good art, dude. Did you draw it? Nice boogie. Yeah, not scripted, true. Oh, is that the only reason C sharp isn't as fast? What? You drew all the art? Yeah, buddy. Dude, nice. Yeah, right on. Heck, I can't wait to play this game. Okay, so what do we got so far? We're in this like loop, so and it's looking for the closest point to 700, and now we're at 600. Right, P should be 600. Good. Okay, so let's see what happens. If area has map pause P, that should return no. And what do we get? False. Good. Or this one? Good. All right. So what's the current disk squared? 144. We should easily be able to beat this. So disk squared. Wait, no. What's the max disk squared? Max disk squared is 49. The current disk squared should be like one. Wait, whoa. Here's the problem. 169? We're like one away. So there's the problem. Okay, let's start this over one more time. Oh. Scanner drone, scan my little buddies. Run to the next point. Okay, so we determined that it's inside this center dot distance squared. Center. And distance squared V3i. Okay, so the current V3i, this should be 700. RHS should be 600. Why would we get 100 and something? Oh. Okay. I'm pretty sure this is because we are in this mode with the V3. Oh, wait, no, V3i. Yeah, V3i is the integer version. Okay. What's wrong with this? Int t, red equals 0, t equals x plus rhx, s dot x. What? It's supposed to be minus. X minus. Has this basic function been that messed up this whole time? And why did I write this function like this? This is really ugly. Guess I was going for performance or something. X minus RHS dot X. So if we have 7 as your X, we subtract out 6 to get 1 and square that. Why? Okay, this should really help fix that. That was messed up. That was definitely not a distance equation at all. What else is messed up in the game because of that?
What's up, babe?
Okay, looking forward to seeing what that fixes. Yeah. Oh, keep it pixely, but you know. Nice, dude, nice vector work. I thought he had his arms behind his back at first, but now I see he doesn't actually have any arms. This is C minus minus. Boogie, dude, boogie, we need a C minus minus. It's like C, but not even as featured. I know, a unit test would really, really help that out, right, Zeith? But I'm not one to write unit tests, usually. Yeah, look at that. The map's filling up. Cool. Let's see how much of this map actually gets filled up. That's a vector 3, I, not 1, which means integer. So it's a vector of integers. And RHS is right-hand side. Yes, of course it is. It's a test. What are those? What's up, professional novice? C minus minus coming right up. It's interesting. You can only include H files, which in turn. Interns would be great, yeah. Math. Professional novice, did I get far in the world poopy? No. But I fixed a lot of the bugs which were stopping me from playing poopy. So once this time, now that the bugs are fixed, poopy is definitely not as poopy. It's way less poopy. There's definitely less poop involved in playing that world. Looks like these drones are going ahead and filling this whole map. Yes, yes, yes. B minus minus. Tests are a form of virus. No, Manic V3I is not a type. That's just a class that I've created. Right. I'm sorry. It is. It's a happy blob, but oh. Yeah. He's smiling. Okay, so look how much of the map it filled up. That was a bit too much for the overworld. I'd rather see that fill up only. How many was that? 50 or so? Poopy. Yeah. It's my own class. Okay, so less. We want to do less of the world filling up. I'm pretty sure that's over here. What's better, B minus minus or B flat? Of course, B flat. But B minus minus is more programmery. I don't know. This one's up for debate. Leaving this up for debate for sure. So 50, okay, wait, the world is 128 tiles. So 50 was actually pretty good. Maybe a little less though. I felt like it did a little too much. So 128 times maybe 0.4 would be 50. Oh, 128 times 0.3 would be around 38. How about 42? 42 would be cool because we're honoring Douglas. Adam Douglas. Is his name Adam Douglas? Not Adam. Douglas Adams? Douglas Adams. Sorry. 38 or 32 is also a good number. Let's try 38 at first. Ah, 42. Let's do that one more time. We can kill these breakpoints now that meth is so fixed. It's so fixed. Oh, we don't need this whole nonsense that I put in here. Set that breakpoint anymore. And we're good to go. This is C sharp D. Oh. In music? No. Nope. Right? What? What about distance squared? Oh yeah, I am using distance squared, but it doesn't really matter compared to distance because I'm just comparing distance squareds versus other distance squareds. C sharp sharp is D, right. Dude, this is the funniest chat ever. Whoa, wow. But they are the same note, but if you put them in context, C sharp and D flat are different. It is. It totally is. Real men program in math, just pure math. Yeah. Yeah, no, Z, there's nothing below this point. It's like if you think of the Zelda 1 world, I'm actually kind of going for a similar type of shape for the world and start point. So, yeah, there's nothing below. I do need to fix those pixels. It's not lining up with those green pixels. Basically, most of the time. Yeah, it's supposed to do that. Because that's all there is above you. Yeah, the frequency is the same. The tone's the same. Everything's the same about those two notes except in context. So if you're looking at a whole musical composition, a C sharp can feel, I guess, if there's a different feel, different context. There's really nothing mathematically different about them. Am I right about that, Loeb? I could be wrong about that. Legit game dev help request. I need suggestions on a game engine and accompanying programming language for my game. I want to build a program very similar to the original Zelda graphics-wise, but I want to do four worlds with it, if that makes a difference. You got a lot of options here. What platforms do you want to release to? Square map area for a rectangular map? It's not. It's a... Wait. A square map area? Huh? No, but I've wanted to. Oh. Maybe I should work on that. Okay, so this time let's save progress here. No, let's not. Let's do one more time. I want to change this right here, so X pair, so it's gonna reveal secrets. If center dot z is greater than yeah, so it's gonna, those like holes in the map that it was revealing there, those shouldn't be there because they're too much. They're revealing the fact that those are secrets. So in fact, this whole bit of code here might just need to be commented out. So I'm gonna do that so I can easily comment that out later if I want. Unnecessary. It depends on the key signature of the piece. Ah, right. Yeah. You intend to release the Windows, Mac, Linux, and Xbox. What language do you want to program in? True, true. Okay, I'm just gonna fix the map's position in the, where is this, draw map, and boss rooms, rooms. Center, okay, center is the map center point. Map center. Ah, so it's area set map. I do this when right when the player is just opening up the gear menu. And we just want to set this offset here to be three more above, I think. Maybe less. If we go let's just guess for a moment. So if I take out a good, like, 20 or so. Yeah, let's try 100. This will move the map, so it might feel a little bit better, right? Zeith was saying that basically the map looked like it was a little bit too high for, that's because it was centering on your current position, which was at the bottom of the map, so that's why it seemed that way. But if I move the map a little bit, so now it needs to be three more pixels up. So 103. Yeah, Irokoken, great advice here to no input Akuma. I definitely would recommend trying multiple engines as well. Ah. Right, so what do we got? Oh yeah, cool. Now we got the map centered and it's a little lower. And this time it should reveal the map without any holes. Oh, you have to have the studio version to get your Mac or whatever? Yeah, yeah. Oh, so there you go. Oh, it's an older version. Oh, that's an interesting idea, Zeith. I would have to do some programming for that. Like, I really want to get on to doing these other things today, but I think I'm gonna add that to the list. So it would draw some no more dots where things couldn't exist. I don't know if that would work as well for dungeons. Dungeons can be all sorts of shapes, but for the overworld, that might make sense. I agree. That's cool. We're getting a nice triangle shape this time because we're not ignoring s these areas. So this is 38, or was it 42? 42. This is 42 areas. Ah, so I almost want to give the player either 41 or 43, so it creates some more of a. Actually, if you took off 1, 2, 3, it would be pretty cool, which would be 39. Let's do 39. Let's settle on that number for now. 39 it is. So this is where we launched drones. Drones. Oh, area, drones, do 39. Oh no, we got bots already. Thank you, mods. Right, PETA, see you, man. Later, later. Okay, good. All right, you know what? I'm ready to cross the first thing off the list. Overworld. Oh, second thing. No more overworld map. Let's check out the compass now. See if that works. Hopefully, I saved. Oh, I didn't save. Damn. All right, well, let's give the player the compass, anyways. So, zero item compass. Huh, why didn't I? Okay, that's weird. I'm not seeing the. I know, so many these days. Yeah, it did. It grew on Sunday when I played the alpha version that like grew like 30 items or something crazy. Man, that means I kind of have to wait for this. Okay, so let's start looking at the code. Let that guy just run. Why didn't this work? Oh, I forgot to put a zero. That's all. Oh. Yeah, so okay, I'm gonna wait for this to finish doing its thing. It's almost there. No, the alpha's not out yet. There's some work left to do. It's gonna come out for sure next Wednesday. That's the date I'm shooting for. I've got a lot of programming left to do, some art left to do, and some playthroughs to do, some people to send it to first. And also, I really want to update the marketing for the game. There's a lot of old images and stuff. I want to update all the screenshots, update the trailer video. I'm gonna send it out to a whole bunch of YouTubers that have been requesting it. And basically, yeah, so that's why I'm kind of setting the date for next Wednesday. I didn't quite get it done in September, but oh well, it'll be next Wednesday, early October. Yeah. Bot Bane. Oh yeah, I didn't put it on YouTube because I guess I was kind of embarrassed. I rage quit on my own game. I'm like, stupid world. The world poopy was really pissing me off because it didn't have this one bridge going to the this one island, so I couldn't get to level one. So I was like, dude, what the hell? Blah blah blah. And I quit. So that's kind of why I didn't. And I already had another video I had to upload that day, so I just did the other video. Okay, so now we got that saved. Yay, now we got all these positions. And we'll go zero. Should be able to use the compass now. All right, so the compass should be able to reveal the biodetector. I'm calling it the compass, but it's technically called the biodetector. This should locate level one for us. Oh, this is not going to work at all. It shouldn't work. Because there is no boss on the overworld. So we need to redo the code for that. So it works based on looking for level one versus looking for world, get boss paws, right? We don't want to do that. We just want to go get the position of level one. So we need a new method. We're going to need a world method that returns the entrance position. So we got get boss paws for Z. Let's also get a get entrance paws for Z. So this is going to search for through the current or the given Z, looking for, oh, you know what? We need a from Z and a to Z. So like I would pass in 0 for the overworld and then 2Z like level 1. So 0, 1, we return the entrance on the overworld to level 1. So we need to write this method. I think I've already done something similar here. So it gets destructed and or it just goes out of scope. It automatically frees up the memory because it's using stack memory. Is it true? Oh yeah, were you asking about news or are you asking about like plain old data? Yeah, true. Does not kick in. There is no such thing. Okay, so get entrance pause. That's actually similar to this method here. So we're going to look through areas from Z, Y pair dot first, X pair dot second dot get flags, and K flag entrance, and get flag number. So let's get the flags. Equals 2z, then we return this position. That should do it. Yes, yeah, Manic. True, man. Yep. Yep, yeah, Mars Power, good example here. This is you're locating it on the stack. This is where you're locating it on the heap, where you have to do your own memory management. So heap allocation versus stack allocation. Very important concept to understand in C++ and C as well. Nice. Yeah, right, yeah. Pete and Wally, yeah, the major thing I'm working on today is being able to guide the player a little bit towards level one if they're feeling lost. So there, I'm adding two new items. There's a map and a compass for the overworld. So I just finished the map item. Basically, you can buy it. You're going to be able to buy it from the store. It'll be like 50 diamonds or whatever, something pretty kind of low, but a little bit high. So if you find the store and you're kind of lost, You can buy this map, you use it, and it reveals about a third of the overworld. And then and there's also going to be the compass item. So this is something where if you've wandered around for a while, like maybe 10 or 15 different screens, you haven't found anything of note, you're going to encounter a mini boss, which you get the compass from, and the compass will put a little red dot on your map where level one is. So it's kind of helping the player along. And there will also be some story items too, so... Yeah, totally. There are. There's lots of good C-sharp tutorials. I'm sure these guys got suggestions for you. Need a map to the map? Yeah. Now all we need to do here is turn this into V3IP. Now, if the... current Z is zero, then the position we're looking for is world get entrance. World get entrance. What the heck? Oh, there. That's why that wasn't working. Entrance pause from Z zero to Z one. Dungeon one. That's all we're looking for. Otherwise, we're looking for the boss on the current level. And then drone reveal, that's good. P dot is valid. This is okay. All right, good. Yeah, definitely good for speedrunning. Oh, wait. Why did the map have... Oh, I think I know. I was wondering why the map doesn't have any X's, but I'm pretty sure that's because I haven't explored those areas yet. All right, cool. So there it is. Is this world poopy? I think this is actually the world poopy. Okay, let's do a test. Let's make sure it saves that position. Oh, yeah, this is world seed poopy. All right, so we're playing poopy, and this is revealed that the level is up there in the top right. Okay, so it lost the boss's position, and we lost our compass. So we don't want that to happen. We need to save this ability. Oh yeah. Oh, the GUI box. Oh yeah. Huh. Okay, I'll have to think about that because I'd have to redesign the graphics, but there could be some solution there because it would have to kind of match the items, and right now there's two sets of items. Yeah, I guess I could do a map in the top, like up here. Huh, that would actually really probably simplify everything. Because then maybe the text could go in the down here in the middle, and then these things could be expanded a little bit. Okay, I'll think about that. Okay, so next bug. All right, Marza, see you, man. Good night. Yep. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. I'm gonna fix this later. So compass, compass on the overworld doesn't stick. Now, okay, so that works well enough. Let's make an overworld map where you can purchase, or you can, where you purchase the overworld map from the store. That's pretty easy. So, elements, overworld items, store items. Oh, overworld items. So the next overworld item is going to be a compass zero. And store items. Let's make the bomb container be in the next store. And then we'll get this. The map in the first store. And I'll have to, I guess I can buy it again. Okay, let's see where the store is at in this world. I'm just gonna cheat, find out where that store is. In the world, poopy. Okay, it's right to the left. So there's a store right to the left of the home screen. All right, so here's the store. Let's see if we can buy the map now. Zero. Can I buy something at zero? It was free. Death just sold me that for free. Come on, dude. Charge something. Component. Map. Here we go. So zero is purchasable for 50. Compass zero, not purchasable. Oh yeah, and there's no equipable flag on these because they're sometimes they're equipable, sometimes they're not. All right, so I don't know what these, do those look? I guess they're all right. I'm not sure they actually visually tell what that item really is. I mean, I kind of get the feel for this is health because it's down there in the bottom right. That does look like a cactus, but this, I'm not sure if those look enough like a map. I'm not sure. Oh! I don't have the money for this. Let's give the player some money. Diamond 55. All right, see you, Marza. Oh, instant death button. So nice to have in debug mode. Oh, does that kill this guy? Oh no, it doesn't kill that guy. Oh, what if I try and launch him here? Oh yeah, you should not equip these. Oh, that's a total bug. So you should not be able to equip. Those should not be auto-equipped in this area. That's pretty important. So let's go fix that. When you pick up an item, sometimes it auto-equips it. So these maps. And area.getPaws.z is greater than 0. Or actually, this a better way to do this would be world is level area.getPaws.z. So there. Now we should be able to go inside there, buy this map, and it's not going to equip it until you get out. It's true, right? They didn't really explain what items were. Yeah. Can you fight the shopkeeper? Not really, not yet. But you can fight the shopkeeper in Zelda, so this should be doable, right? Yeah, Pedro, I haven't even worked on the store since I first created them for the last alpha version, which is really more like a preview version. But yeah, I've really got to do some work in this item store. I just haven't really prioritized that yet. But yeah, this should be a lot better. I mean, he's actually going to be behind a counter or something like that, and these will actually be up on a counter, and it'll just be a lot more, you know, more 2015 rather than 1980. Not 80. When did Zelda 1 come out? 85? 84? 90? Not 90. So can I use the drones again? Oh yeah, I can use twice the drones. Fill the whole map. You can steal from the Shink. Oh, that's right. If you got into his back door or whatever, you climb through his back door. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, something. There'll definitely be some improvements somehow to the store. Right? It is Death Mart, right, Ray Bro? 86, is that? Oh, 86. Okay. So, alright, so that's good. We now have a map that is purchasable from the first store. So let's cross that one off the list. Next thing, let's create a mini boss encounter that grants you the overworld compass. So this shouldn't be too hard. I need to create a special type though. I need to create a new type of enemy, but we need to create a story element. So we'll go mini boss one on the Z if you have the sword and you have like 10 positions, maybe more like 12. So you start feeling lost. You haven't found level one yet. Oh, we would also need something to indicate that you haven't found level one, too. So that, Nah, I mean, I guess you can have this encounter after level one. It's not too much of a bug. So let's do a blob mini boss for now. Might do a different one. So let's duplicate drop mini boss, do a blob mini boss. We can use the art for the big blobs, but not the big boss bobs. Whoa. Okay. So yeah, the same look as blob three. Same look and behavior as Blob 3, but just more health to start with. We don't need skins. Just got the default skin, it's all we need. We can change this to be something other kind of look or whatever. Health, not 6.0, but this is gonna be more like, how much is the drop boss, mini boss guy? All right, see ya, Pedro. Same thing, you guys, all you guys. PMC, good night, you guys. So the drop guy has 6. This guy can have maybe 10, maybe 12. 12 would be a lot more. Okay, see if that works. We got 10 positions. I think that means that if I go, I don't know what it means for these negative positions. Let's see if we encounter this mini boss. Easter egg. Oh, the blob boss is right here. Okay, so these map positions count. Easter egg idea. The shopkeeper can sometimes be holding a sword and you can challenge him for free loot. Cool. I like it. Easter egg idea on the ideas list. But if you die, the game is completely over. It's only 6:30. Yeah, nice. You're so close to me. In time zones. Yeah. Well, there's also, keep in mind, there's permadeath mode for this game. So permadeath mode, you know, when you die, you can't continue. So if you're speedrunning in permadeath mode, it's automatically going to be that way. This guy should have max intelligence. Why doesn't he have max intelligence? Or does he? It's not that hard. Oh, he gave me the top hat? That's not what I want. Alright, so there's one little bug. Gave me the wrong item. Yeah, there's permadeath. Yep, he's been permadeath for a while now. But yeah, permadeath mode, when you die, there's no continue. So that's going to be like the ultimate speed run, right? If you're speed running and you're also in permadeath mode, I think those are going to give you the highest scores. Right, if you complete the whole game and you get every item there is and you're in permadeath mode, that's going to be like the top score on the leaderboard. Well, I know why. So the way overworld items work is it pops them off the list. Oh, do I already have the top hat? Oh yeah, you should just keep popping things off the list. Yeah. You mean permadeath? Yeah, I mean, I can even switch this game into permadeath mode if I just type permadeath. But I don't want to. Oh, yeah. Keep popping things off the list. If we're filling, we're setting the boss item. Here it is. Oh, that's something different. That's another type of boss item setting. This isn't it. It's not set boss item. It's in world. It's in system. When it's running the story system. Foe item, here it is. Spawning a foe, giving it items. So we really need to keep popping items off the list. All right, Loeb, good night, man. Get some sleep tonight. Do we have the player? We just get the player pretty easily, so. Or gear. We'll get the gear. So auto ref gear equals area, get heroes, front dot gear, gear dot count, item is greater than zero. Keep looping. Item equals world pop item. And then, yeah. So there. What's up, MC Finest Gold? You're asking what games that I've purchased that I have on Steam? Or games that I've created that I have on Steam? Okay. Possessed. All right, let's try it again. All right, so this is, I'm ripping through this list pretty fast, actually. This is all intended to help guide the player, especially if they're feeling lost, to get to the first dungeon. After the first dungeon, it's a fend for yourself kind of game. Whoa, boss right there. What? No exit spikes? You must not have found the item. Oh, it's because I already have the compass. Okay, so if I gotta get rid of that, turn off the compass. Yeah, cool. This time we have exit spikes on this area. This guy should definitely be a little harder. Yay! And now I'm gonna use it. The only thing we gotta do now is get it to save it and test it out a little bit. You guys still there? Did the stream die? Oh, okay, cool. All right, next will be to test this out. I guess let's start this world over a little bit. Oh, and also get it to save. No. All right, cool. I love the guys that said no, both you guys. Oh, you're Pierre-ing. Nice. You want Marza back? It definitely creates conversation, right? And PETA. They're always like, I love the jokes they throw at each other. What's up, Spymort? What's up, man? All right, next thing, I want to get it so it saves that position for the boss. Okay, so we can cross this off the list now, too. So we got this mini boss encounter. Do want to check it, though. But also, let's do this. Compass overworld doesn't stay after saving. So, how can we do that? If you have the compass, then you have a boss pause. I think I already did this for dungeons, but maybe I just didn't. No, not tests, just working on bugs for the alpha version. So this Sunday I played the alpha version, noted like a ton of things, and now I'm still trying to get through my list of those things. So the alpha version is coming out next Wednesday, and anybody that's pre-ordered at the highest level or backed it on Kickstarter, they're the ones getting it. And also a few different YouTubers and other people that I'm going to send for marketing purposes and stuff like that. So yeah, just working on the alpha version. I'm pretty sure I have a mechanism that saves the boss position. Reset boss pause. Oh, so easy. Pause.z is zero. Boss pause is world get entrance pause. See if that works. Oh, one more thing. When it draws the map, there's this thing where it draws the boss room, little red dot, and that thing needs to be up a little higher and a little more to the right. So let's go 4-3. Think it's almost time to actually play it. Maybe I'll do a playthrough right now, actually. Because that'd be a good way to test this out. Jeez, get this guy against the wall and he's easy. Definitely gotta improve that guy. Okay, we've launched the drones. Shows up on the map. Good, it's centered now. Let's save. Continue. Yeah, nice. Save that boss position. Cool. You propose the word fart? All right, fart it is. Let's play this. Actually, let's improve the boss really quick. Let's make the boss a little bit better, a little bit more fun. And then we'll play it. Yeah, so and let's cross this off the list. One more thing done. And what can make this boss better, you ask? I think he should be smarter. Oh, actually, no, his charge. There. So there. If we do really, really either nothing or actually, he shouldn't be that smart, but like really, really, really high chance that he's going to do this speed up towards you type thing. Wow, you can even spawn. Let's not have him spawn stuff. No one. Well, wandering's okay. Slowing down, yeah, we'll keep all these. Forgetting, no. It never forgets you. Okay, let's hope this is better. Codes like on Metroid for NES. Okay, why don't we have him? I want to fight the guy. Help me fight the guy. Let me fight the guy. I want to. Oh, probably because I've got mini boss one in the saves. Yeah. Oh, he's definitely harder now. Yeah, look at that. Whoa, 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 dude, whoa. Oh, yeah, this is way more interesting. Ah, almost died. And this might be a little bit hard for players at the beginning of the game. I feel like I barely survived that. You should have a little bit less health. Let's tweak that a little bit. This guy is not going to have 10 health, but maybe 8 health. He's super fast, right? I don't know. Disable keyboard support. Yeah, it's good if it's hard, right? But this is supposed to be the very beginning of the game. So that's why I'm trying to make it not too hard. I don't want it to be like games nowadays where they're too easy, but I also don't want it to quite be like old days where games were a little bit too hard. I don't know. I almost feel like games are a tiny bit too hard back in the Nintendo days. Like Skate or Die, one of the hardest games I've ever played. It's hard to even make it out of the initial shop in that game. Ah. So it really depends on where you encounter this guy. Ah. Dude, he's so jittery. He's fast. Whoa. I still almost died. Cool. Yeah, that guy's hard. But I guess that's good enough, right? You should stay that way. The only thing about this guy is you're forced to fight him. You're forced to beat him as well, so. All right, let's do it. Let's play the game. Skate or Die, yes. It's so hard. I don't know. Okay, we're doing it. We're starting the game over. I'm gonna get my controller. Yeah, playthrough. Man, I didn't even expect to get this far today. Oh, you know what? Oh man, there's one more bug we gotta fix first. This shouldn't be too hard to fix. The boss guy. Shoot. Let's keep this world really quick. Yeah, definitely mix. Battletoads, yes! Battletoads is one of my favorite games too. Such a good game. I replayed it the other day with my friend, and we got lost at first. Remember how you have to throw stuff at the camera? That was a really confusing part. So this one thing here, the boss gets stuck and starts walking to the left. See if we can figure that out, because this... No, you know what? Let's just play the game. I can fix this later, and hopefully we don't encounter this boss. Yeah. All right, let's play it. Let's play the game from the start. The word is going to be fart. Firekoken already called it. So we should be able to just go. I'm going to turn my open broadcaster into game mode, so it's going to be black for a second. And now it should be okay. Yeah, I think this is all right. Let me know if it's not, though. Oh, wait. Sorry, hold on. I gotta turn this into movie mode so I can see you guys chat. Yeah, two players so hard. Two-player Battletoads. Okay, I think we're good. I'm probably going to encounter. It's not centered? Is it centered now? I think it's centered now. Better? Okay, cool. Alright! World fart. We ready to do this? Wait, hold on. Got a little bit. I should minimize this guy. There we go. New game. Regular mode, not permadeath. Should I do permadeath? Let's do permadeath. No, I don't want to do permadeath. Because if I die on that one boss, I want to test out continue mode and all that. Yeah. I gotta do regular mode for testing purposes. That's 3 A's. Fart. We've done fart and poopy. Man, the last few playthroughs have been hilarious. Hopefully this is not as bad as poopy was at first, but Because the bugs are fixed, most of them. Blood's a good, that's a good word. Blood? Yeah, testing purposes, in quotes. But I really do need a test to continue. If I die, I don't want to actually die and try and continue. And when I continue, it should save all of my map but and other stuff that I've collected, but put me back in the position where I last was. So that's one thing to check, right, before this alpha comes out. All right, here we are. World Fart. Yes, yes he is. Cool, Spymore. Yeah, there's more plot. I'm kind of skipping through it. But yeah, there's more plot to see. And there's more to be added, too. And even before this alpha comes out, I'm going to have some more plot elements to help you kind of point you in the right direction a little bit and also clue you into using your teleport, because you start with your teleport cube and you can actually teleport at the very beginning of the game. So you can go back to your ship Songbringer immediately if you want. Visit the Droidsmith. What's up, Droidsmith? But you can't do anything with the Droidsmith just yet. Oh, the player lost his top hat there. That was a bug. Oh, come back and boom, you gotta fight this guy. Hope you're ready. Ah. Yeah, homing drone. Such a useful item. Which way should I go? Left, right, up? I'm going left until somebody tells me otherwise. Oh, a store! Nice! Too bad. Don't got any money. Yeah. Up? You want me to go up? Alright, I'll go up. Two calls for up. Nice. I like it when you guys are in sync. Three calls for up. Oh, I missed a diamond. Birds. The birds don't do anything yet. But I think eventually they might have some kind of secret associated with them. Well, now that there's something interesting to buy from the store, I'm actually kind of more motivated to save up money. Find diamonds and stuff. That's cool. Yeah, cactus. Oh, there should be an item. It should tell you that you, when you first get the cactus, you want to go diagonal? Let me take some notes. So when you first get the cactus, it should say something like, oh, this is the cactus. This is what you were looking for. Cactus shows item text on first one. The birds poopy and fart. Oh, nice. Make them like the cuckoos? What do you mean? What do we have here? Oh, a dead end? I'm thinking maybe the left edge of this lake might have something. Aiding them can lead to great things. Harming them can lead to your doom. Ah. Very interesting. I like that. Yeah, they definitely need to have some sort of secret purpose. Right now, they just fly around the overworld. So they actually migrate. Like, if you were to follow their location, they do actually move. So whenever you scare them, They moved to a new location. Oh, we're locked in here with the blob boss and he's stuck. Oh, that's a bug on my list already. I forgot. I need to make it so blob the mini boss encounters only occur if you're on an area. I wonder why he started on that though. Yes, nice. We have the map, the compass. Dude, that was really nice. But I think I want that to be a little bit farther, a little bit deeper into the. So, deeper for second mini boss. And second mini boss on what area is this? 530? 530 fart. Started on trees. Okay, get that fixed. More bugs. Always finding bugs. Maybe it'll lead you to a secret dungeon. Cool. Deeper, you say. Thanks, I'm glad you like the water art. Oh, cool. Check it out, refill. Take it. It's not no dungeon one. Oh, I gotta use the freaking compass. Cool. We got, does it show? Oh, look, it's right there. It is the other lake point. Right? So there's level one. Yeah, I'm thinking this way is the way to go. Oh my gosh, it helps so much to have that. Because there's no Nintendo Power for this game. At least not yet. They give you the ice beam and the Varia suit. Yeah. Oh man, I love Metroid so much. It's probably why so much of this game is influenced by Metroid and Zelda. Both those things are my... I love them. Love them, love them, love them. Ah. Oh yeah, two cactuses. Jib amiibo? What? Oh, nice. It's a nice little combo, except I'm down on health. Top hat is so useful. Love it. Love Metroid 2. Playthrough, yes, yeah. What seed is fart? Yeah, Boogie told you. Nice. Oh yeah, you gotta play Metroid, man. So dope. Start with, I don't know, what Metroid should you start with? I would say Super Metroid is my favorite. But I don't know, should you start with Super Metroid or regular old school Metroid? Yeah, the music is so good in Metroid. So good. I love the controls in Metroid too. The physics are really, really good. Oh no, this is a hard dungeon to find. Once again, we have a difficult level one. You know what? I do have an idea how to fix that too. Oh man, am we stuck here? So it looks like the entrance is either, man, that's a no, I can't get anywhere else in that one. Looks like we gotta go try walking around the whole lake again. Fusion? Yeah, it is, very pretty game, right? Wait, so if we were to come down, there's a path, but it's way up there. Dude, this is like the hardest level to find. It's so far. Yeah, when you throw your top hat, yeah. I've just ignored that fact so far in the game's development. You just get your top hat back. But I guess I can make it so it. Whoa, another cactus. I guess I could make it so the top hat like actually keeps on coming back to you. I can do that. I'll add that to the list. I can put it at least on the low priority items. Top hat. Even if you're off screen, you get the top hat back. All right, let's see if we can get to level one from this way. So one of the things on my list is actually to make it so it uses a distance algorithm for every one of the dungeons. So instead, right now it uses an actual, just like a Manhattan algorithm, I guess is what you would call it. It's just city block style as the crow flies. That's basically how the game determines how far or how deep a level is, right? So level one, it's like it used that Manhattan a crow flies algorithm. And it determined that, oh, level one is really close, so let's put level one here. But really, it shouldn't use that algorithm. It should use the depth of like if you use like a star pathfinding or something like that to determine how difficult it is to get to a dungeon entrance. So that's on my list, and it's a really high priority item. So I'm going to do that so that next time you play this world, Fart or Poopy, Poopy as well was like that. Where Poopy had level one inside a really, really hard to get to level one place on an island. So it won't be so difficult to get to those things because it'll use that A star algorithm instead of Manhattan. Let's hope we can get to it, because I really want to play level one this time. It's got the best art so far, the most refined art. Oh no, I don't think we're gonna be able to get to it this way. Oh, unless I had the blink. If I had the blink orb right now, we would be at that level already. Oh, level two. All right, we'll take it. Okay, so once again, what I'm talking about here is we've explored this world a little bit, and level two was easier to find than level one. And so that's basically a bug. It's on my list, and I do have a good idea how to fix that. Yeah, I'm playing with the controller. I got my little NES or Super NES style gamepad. It's a really great one. If you're looking for a good Super Nintendo USB controller, this is called the iBuffalo, and it's actually pretty good. It's great. It's a great feel. It's almost the exact same weight as the Super Nintendo, but it's USB. All right, so we're going to level two. This one has different art than level one, and I haven't finished the art for this. So you're seeing art that's like just not that good yet. But it's still playable. Guys are dumb. I really gotta make it so enemies never. I gotta write this down because enemies really get stuck on the edges. That's so easy to fix. Enemies should never get stuck on edges because they're randomly choosing directions and stuff. Oh my god, watch this. Thank you for deleting that, whoever deleted him. Yeah, total bot. What? This guy had a sword. Oh my god, this is so weird. Are you guys seeing this? I just killed this dropped enemy guy, and he dropped the sword. What was that about? Give me this location. Well, I have no idea. 332. 332. World Fart had a drop with the freaking sword. What? Okay. Joe the Miz. Yeah, I know. What's up? What's up with these bots? Somebody, I think somebody wrote a freaking bot for TwitchCon. You know, TwitchCon just happened and all that. There's a lot of tension on Twitch. Oh, nice. You got bombs. Bomb container. Bam. And I think I have that comes with a few bombs, so we can use these. Foes walk in place while they're paused. Yeah. That should be noted for sure, right? Same thing with flies. The flies just sit there hovering in place. Thanks, man. Thank you. Cheers, Joe. Yeah, that's more of a low priority one, but yeah. Foes walk in place while pause. Basically, the whole game should actually pause. You know? I can do that by actually pausing the tick. The red dot appears in the map, does it? Oh no. Good point. Very good point, Raybro. Thank you. Good call. Good call. Good call. Nice. Thanks for noticing that. The red dot appears in dungeon 2 part. Whoa, we got another bot, dude. What's up with these bots? Ban. Sorry, we had to ban that guy. What's that's two bots in a row, like within 5 minutes of each other. Or less. Wait. That guy was already banned? Oh, wait. It must have been Vlad banning him. I love these corridor rooms. These are pretty cool. We got. Oh, these guys are dark. Oh, whoops. You wasted a bomb. Oh, didn't waste a bomb. They're so dark on this level here. Yay! I got seven cactuses. I should start using these. Even Twitch Boss loves Songbreaker. What's up, Fun? Arcore, no. CocoSudiX does not require Macs. You can use it on Windows, Linux, even. Macs, yeah. Oh, death. Death comes. So I should still have my map. Good. It does have what I explored so far. Did keep that bug with it kept my items too. Good. That's what I'm expecting. Oh, hold on. Oh, did it rip? Don't tell me it ripped. Arcor, oh. We almost had five. There you go. Nice effort. Way to run it in. I don't even know what I just did there in the game. Right? I was like, I can't play while there's four. Now you guys know what to do to distract me during any one of these playthroughs. You want me to die, right? If I'm playing in permadeath mode, I know there's gonna be like four BC warriors. I'm gonna be like, no, it's four BC warriors. I got so many cactuses. There's been a lot of them. Oh no, I gotta use a cactus, I'm almost dead. Oh, what? Oh, it almost, oh. I can't believe I just died twice. I guess I am on level 2. This should be a little harder than level 1. Okay, don't fight them. Those guys are hard. Don't fight them. Don't give in to the temptation to fight those guys. Oh, these guys look easy. Oh yeah. The hat works really good for fighting these guys. Is it just me or is every single enemy getting items? Nope. Okay, not every single enemy, but quite a few enemies. Yeah, you can eat the cactuses. Yep, so when you eat a cactus, you get psychedelic powers. You can see secret walls. So if there are any secret walls or whatever here, I'll be able to see them. And also, you're invincible. So I'm totally invincible right now. I can go run around and not even die. Not even get hurt. But only for a little bit. Where are we at? I'm back at this place. I have the blue thing. Whoops. Oh, I just realized why that sound dies sometimes. It's the Coco Studio X sound engine. It sometimes stops sounds that are currently running because it sucks. No, but really, it's kind of a poor design of a sound engine, I think. Yay, we got the yellow password. What's behind the yellow doors? This guy looks hard. Kill him first! Kill him! Oh, you weren't hard at all. Because your intelligence is not very high in Dungeon 2. That was a dead end, I think. Oh, secret item. Very easy to see. What's up? I'm not getting slowed down. Let's try that again. Oh, his slow field's not working. Come on, that's a bug. That whole blue light should slow me down. It's like a freezing fog. Right, yeah. It was obvious. What do we get? Gimme. Oh, map. So, okay, what's going to happen with this map or this compass thing? Compass. Now, because there's already a boss position on here, is this going to reveal the same position? Probably. Oh, no, it moved it. All right. Can I make a dungeon track for the alpha release? Song, you mean? Oh, cool, we found the boss door. But it looks like we're at a dead end here. Oh, here we go, cool. Let's use some bombs to fight these guys. Yeah, 2-1. That should be some achievement. Or at least an item. A story element. That's a cool story element. You kill two enemies with a bomb at once. You should say something. Oh my God. No, you watch this. Right, cool. We got this thing hooked up. The switch, I mean, it's turned on. Hopefully, this is not the boss that's broken. Oh, it's the broken boss. Well, hopefully, he doesn't break this time. Nice hit, dude. Oh, I got hit with my own bomb. Yeah, this guy's super broken. We need Caxes. Yeah, this is the broken boss right now. He's very broken. Oh, now he's almost dead. He's moving faster. So this is where he gets broken. Yeah, well, his animations look a lot better when he's actually doing the right stuff. There we go. Cool. At least he's somewhat functional. What is going on? Oh, you know what? I think he hit that item chest with his hammer, and that's why it's jittering up and down like that. Yeah. Oh, the reflection? I didn't even think about that. Okay, so boss hits hidden chest with hammer and it jitters up and down. It something ugly. It's like the most excited item chest ever. Yeah, but item chest. Like a Kappa face. Okay, once again this is a bug I've already noted, where you're supposed to always have the goal room above. So for some reason that goal room didn't get above. And so anyways, we got the ghost sword. The ghost sword's a sweet item. So sweet. And we can warp back. Cool. Yes. Dad, that face is scary. Scary. I don't know why it's scary, but it is. All right, cool. That's it. We played through level two. We played through the original, the mini boss. I noted a lot of things. So how many things did I actually get on added onto my list here? Repeat it for later. If you eat a cactus on a big boss room, you see his true face. Oh, interesting idea. Ghost sword to cut ghost carrots. I like that idea, Vlad. I'm gonna add it to your list. So eating cactus changes boss face. Cool idea. It's a guy with handlebars. He does look like he has handlebars. Wait. Yeah? So wait, how many things did I just add to the list there? About 12. But they're mostly fast items, you know. I could probably rip through 10 of them in a couple hours. All right, so yeah, that's it, I guess, for today's stream. I'm gonna keep on working on some bugs tonight, just like get as many as I can done, and then tomorrow I probably will play through again, I guess. I'm not sure what I'll do tomorrow, but I'll be working on something else. I'll probably be deeper into the list and just working more on those kind of things. So yeah, I know I gotta find level one. That's a big priority for getting done before tomorrow, is using that A-star pathfinding algorithm so that dungeons are always, the first dungeons are always actually closest path-wise, the distance of the path, instead of just the distance as the crow flies. Yeah, so that's it for today's stream. The game you're seeing here, if you guys are just ever seeing this game, it's called Songbringer. It's a procedurally generated Zelda. Nice, it looks fun. Cool, yeah, I know, right? It does. When you're seeing me develop the game, you're not just really seeing me play the game that much. So it does help to show, because there's a lot done already for this game. You know, it helps to go see the game actually being played. Oh, wait, is this level one? So you see what I mean? See how far you had to walk in this level just to get to level one? But this is it, level one right here. Bam. Yeah, thank you guys for joining the stream, and use double A-star. Is there a double A-star, really? I'll take a look. So yeah, I'll be back again tomorrow, same wizard time, and that's it. So good night, you guys. Cheers.